increment borer. Looks like an orange stick, but there's more to it than meets the eye. There we go. This extractor, I'm just gonna set that here. And I'll put the tool together. Comes like this, it snaps on. Notice it's sort of, it's sharp at this end. So I'm gonna take a sample. I'll take it here. You know, it's funny, like I've got a little wound here, so I'm looking for any sort of wounds. This being right in the driveway, that's, you know, some cars knocked it. Wherever there's a wound or a vector for decay, it's possible it could be a lot of decay inside. I don't know. I could have sounded it, like I could have knocked it with a hammer, see what it sounds like. But this is a step further. Put a little pressure. And get it going inside. Here comes the good part. And I always stick it in upside down, kind of the top. In the top. Stick it in as far as it'll go. And what I want to do is loosen up that piece of wood in there. So I'm going to bring it back, shake it around a bit. And there we go. Here is what's going on inside of number 838. What I usually like to do is I'll get a picture of it from here. Then I'll get a picture of it here. Ultimately, what I need to do is have a really good look at it. You want to put it on a piece of paper so you can see it. Of course, you can count the rings and see how old it is or see how old the piece is. You're looking for things that are a bit soft, which this one is. It's got a little bit of decay in there. The other things you can find out, for example, is, well, how fast has it been growing? I can tell that this tree, like over the last several years, like the rings are really close together. See, when the rings are further apart, that's when it's growing well, super healthy. But this tree, given that it's, you know, right at the edge of the driveway, got a big wound at the base and the top was cut off, it's got some things going against it. So anyway, we noticed a little bit of decay and slow growth. So those are the observations I can take. It's what I learned from